टेंथ पेज नंबर 147, पेज नंबर 147, 147। So they are given a few important things till I take note of. One is the theme. What are the themes treated in the poem? Themes. The poem celebrates human values pertaining to kindness, cooperation, and empathy. So one of the words constantly used is values, values in life. What are values? Another word for values? Maybe you can say principles. Principles. All of us follow certain principles in our life. Certain good manners, certain way of behaving, certain way of talking. Our approach to others, our attitude towards the people, all these are a part of the value system. So you have good values, which we inherit from parents. Also there are social values, which we inherit or we get it from the society. By living in the society, we acquire certain values. So in the poem, 9 gold medals, this kind of good values are being discussed. One thing is competition. In Olympic Games, there is tough competition. So competition on the one hand, but on the other hand, you should have certain values in life, certain principles in life that will help you to achieve something in life. Some of the examples for values are truth. Truth is a value. Honesty. Love. So truth, honesty, values. All these are good values we have in the society. Gandhiji, the father of the nation, Gandhiji was holding this value of truth and honesty as something very great. He always stood for the truth. And it's a famous autobiography, My Experiment with the Truth, My Experiment with Truth. So truth was the value he was holding on to. Honesty is another one. You should always be honest. Whatever may be the cost, you should be honest. So competition on the one hand, sportsmanship on the other hand, and certain values in life. So these are the important things you should remember in this poem. One thing is competition. We are speaking about Special Olympics, which is being held once in 2 years. Special Olympics. So that is there. So when you are participating in Olympic Games, you should have a competitive spirit. Today we are living in a world of competition. If you are not able to compete with each other, you are out of the play. You are out of the play. You will be ousted. So competition is needed. But at the same time, you should not be just occupied with the competitive spirit alone. We should have certain principles to follow in life. Those are called values. And regarding sports, we call them sportsmanship. sportsmanship. How a sports person should behave? What should be his attitude towards himself? What should be his attitude towards sports itself? What should be his attitude towards others who are participating? So that is very important. How do I look at myself as a sports person? How do I look at others, those who are participating? And what is my attitude towards sports? So we shall take up the theme. Before that, the theme will have a celebration of human values. On page number 147. Page number 147. So, did you have at least some basic understanding of what is the meaning of values? If you do not understand, then you will not follow the class. So, values are certain principles like truth, honesty, love, etc. that will help us to better our lives, our personal lives as well as our life in the society. They are the values. They give us certain guidance to live as a person who is worthy of living. So the first theme is celebration of human values. Celebration of human values. The poem celebrates human values pertaining to kindness, cooperation, and empathy. The nine runners were participating in Special Olympics to achieve their dreams of winning the gold medal. All of them had been strenuously practicing for months to run and win. But the poem brings out the idea that caring and sharing is much more important than winning and losing. Caring and sharing is much more important than winning or losing. So one side you have winning and losing. Why do you participate in Olympics? Everybody comes with a desire to win. Win what? Gold, silver or bronze. That is their aim. And I have to work hard. They practice before coming. And after coming also, they give themselves the best of their ability in order to win. So winning and losing. Somebody has to win, somebody has to lose. That is part of the game. That is one side. The other side is values like caring and sharing. Care means I care for the other. I have some concern for the other. Love. And sharing means my ability to share with others. What do I share? I can share in others' sorrows as well as in their joys. When somebody is in difficulty, somebody is in trouble, I can share in their difficulty or sorrow. When somebody is enjoying, there is a glorification, enjoyment, I can share in their joy also. So that is caring and sharing. So both are important. Winning, losing is very important. At the same time, values like caring and sharing are also important. That's the main theme of 9 gold medals. Here you should try to understand two words, sympathy and empathy. Sympathy and empathy. Thank you. sympathy and empathy. You are quite familiar with the word sympathy. Say, let's say some few years ago, 10 years ago, the word sympathy was very popular. You should be sympathetic to this. You must be sympathetic towards others. That is, both words come from Greek. Both words come from Greek. The root word is from Greek. And it has a little difference. Sympathy is together. Sympathy is together. Sin and pathy. Sin and pathy. So, plus pathos. Pathos are feelings. So, sympathy comes from the word sin, S-Y-N. S-Y-N, sin means together, pathos, feeling, sympathy, sin. Sin together, pathi is pathos, feelings. That means you feel together. That is sympathy. Suppose I see somebody suffering. For example, now somebody is affected by coronavirus, COVID-19. I feel sympathy for him. I feel sympathy for him. Empathy is coming from empathy. Pathy is again pathos, feelings. M means at or in. At or in. M is at or in. Empathy. At the feeling or in the feeling. This is a little more close. Little more close. I am feeling, able to feel with the person. So for example, a handicapped man. There is a blind man. I see him. I am sympathetic towards him. Means I feel sorry for him that he is blind. I try to help him. Empathy is much more than that. I try to get into his shoes. What it means not having the gift of sight. I am able to feel with him. See, not able to look at the world, the whole darkness. I am able to feel with him. That is empathy. So empathy is much more desired than sympathy. So now these days, the highest value is empathy. So now the author is saying, you should be empathetic towards others. So empathy is a, sympathy is a human value. Empathy is a much higher value. So such a value you should possess. So that is the human values. So competition, winning and losing. One side, opposite, caring and sharing. The second value, we'll go to the second value. True spirit of sportsmanship. True spirit of sportsmanship. See, if you remember these two themes, most of the questions, answers will be there. Most of your assignment questions will be touching upon these two themes. So what is true spirit of sportsmanship? Why do you participate in a game? You participate in a game to win. But just winning alone is not sufficient. You need to be people who can care for others. People who can consider the feelings of others. When somebody is in sorrow, you feel sad with them. Somebody is enjoying, you join in their enjoyment. So that is a true sportsmanship. You remember that? You remember any lesson that we did and spoke about true sportsmanship? Have you forgotten? My greatest Olympic prize by Jesse Owens. And the lesson concludes, Jesse Owens concludes his story quoting from the famous person regarding Olympics. Nayan Godmatraya, Pierre Coubertin's message that the most important thing in the Olympics games is not winning, but taking part and fighting well. Everybody cannot win. Only a few can win. In Olympics, how many can win? The gold, silver and bronze. Only three. Others will lose. So winning is not the important thing. What is important is participating and fighting well. I participate in the game. Yes. How many can participate? As many as allowed. The maximum number of people, that is, every country can send this many people for each item. That's a rule. That many can participate. How many can win? Very limited. So participation, many can participate. And fight well as if you are going to win. You fight as if you are going to win. I fight as if I am going to win. You remember Laszlo? Laszlo was known for his sportsmanship. So, to understand this theme, just remember Laszlo. That's enough. Laszlo, the German, who had to please Hitler, but he did not want to please him because he was an owner of a great value called sportsmanship, true sportsmanship. So, he supported Jesse Owens. When Jesse Owens made fouls and he could not qualify himself, he came and touched his shoulders, encouraged him, pointed out his mistake and helped him to get qualified. Afterwards, he had a wonderful chat with him and helped him to cool down. And he said, you fight and you win. I fight as if I am going to win. At the end, who will win? We will leave it. But important thing is, participate and fight with a good spirit. That is true sportsmanship. Sportsmanship implies that a sport or activity should be enjoyed for its own sake with consideration for fairness, respect and a sense of fellowship with one's competitors. Fairness, respect and sense of fellowship with one's competitors. So by sportsmanship, these are the three things spoken of: fairness, respect, and fellowship with the other. Fellowship with the other. What is fairness? Fair ways, fair means. Always use fair means, means proper ways, justified ways. Justified ways. That is, I don't make use of any other influence just because I belong to some particular country, I belong to a particular race, just because I have certain advantages, all these things I shall not take advantage of. Fairness should be our policy. Fairness should be our policy. All be treated equally. Everybody has a right to participate. Everybody has a right to compete. Everybody has a right to win. So that is fairness. Respect. Respect for each other. I respect the other as a person. I respect the other as a sportsman. I am participating in the game. Another one also is participating in the game. All have come to compete. All have come with a desire to win. All have come to win and go back to their country with a gold, silver or bronze. Therefore, I respect the feelings of others. I don't hurt anybody. Knowingly, I shall not hinder anybody from participating peacefully. That is respect. And what is fellowship with the other? They are also like me. They are also like me. I am there. They are also human beings. Therefore, I will support them when it is needed. So that is true sportsmanship. So this value you should have. These are the two main things. One is the celebration of human values. Second one is true spirit of sportsmanship. Next, we shall go to style. In literature, especially in all the three, in drama or in story or in poetry, especially in poetry, when we speak about style, we are speaking about literary style. Literary style. What are the styles used in writing the poem or explaining the poem? The meters used, figures of speech used. What is the style? Is the narrative style or descriptive, and different styles used? We shall look at it. Actually, this poem we don't have so much of style because it's very simple poem. Narrative technique. The first one is narrative technique. How it is narrated, how the story is, the poem is narrated. Narrative technique. There are certain techniques used in the narration. What are they? The poem is much more like a story that is being narrated. 9 gold medals has been narrated and recorded in a pattern of a song by Roth. The narrator gives us an account of a race organized in Special Olympics. The poem brings out the idea of compassion, teamwork, and sportsmanship through the exemplary behavior of the athletes. So it is much more like a story, not like a poem. Normally, poems have their own stand. That is, their own style, their own rhythm, and the number of stanzas, number of lines in a stanza. All those things are not there here. It is almost like a story being narrated. The narrator of the poem is himself a spectator, a part of the audience, which is known by these lines. His answer to one of the questions asked in the assignment, so please pay attention. So narrator himself is a part of the audience. He is one of the spectators, one who is watching the Olympic event. How do we know the lines? But as sure as I am standing here telling the story, now it's a strange one, but here is what occurred. I am standing here and watching. I'm not speaking about an event. It's not a fantasy. It is not a hooked up story. It is a real event. And I myself am standing here and watching the Olympic game. And as it is happening, that event I have reported. As it occurred. Then it will go to structure. What is the structure? Structure is a, you know, what's the meaning of structure? Shape. Shape or form. Structure is a shape or form of the poem. What is the structure? Is there a fixed structure? No. The poem has 8 stanzas. So many stanzas, 8 stanzas. Of which 7 stanzas have 4 lines each. The last stanza consists of 5 lines. It has no particular rhyme scheme, but follows a rhythm that heightens its effect. So, It has what are altogether 8 stanzas. First 7 stanzas are of equal number of lines, that is 4 lines each. Only the last stanza, 8 stanzas, what are 5 lines. It does not have a rhyme pattern, but the certain amount of rhythm is there. Example: all round the field, spectators were gathered, cheering on all the young women and men. Then the final event of the day was approaching, the last race about to begin. So it heightens the effect of suspense. How does it heighten the effect? All round the field, spectators were gathered. So the stadium was full of people. The crowd was in full number, cheering on all the young women and men. They were all cheering the participants. Then the final event of the day was approaching. Here, Rohit is speaking about one particular event, that is 100 meters race. Or sometimes they call it 100 meters dash. So it was that particular event, and the final was just about to begin. The last race about to begin. How the suspense is built up. So only in this manner the rhyme is used. Otherwise there is no exact rhyme scheme in the poem. Then figures of speech used. There is alliteration. Alliteration. You have come across alliteration many times. You are familiar with this alliteration. It is the close repetition of consonant sounds, usually at the beginning of words. So, in a verse, in the line, the consonant sounds are repeated, not vowel sounds. Consonant sounds are repeated. For example, his dreams and his efforts dashed in the dirt. The D sound, the sound is repeated. His dreams and his efforts dashed in the dirt. So in all the three words, dreams, dashed, dirt, the D sound, D sound is repeated. So that is alliteration. But the youngest among them stumbled and staggered. S sound is repeated. So that is alliteration. And the fourth point is climax. You know what is a climax? Climax is a point, the height of point wherein the person or the persons involved in the story, in the poem or drama, they feel they are important. So all the activities coming to the highest point, from then onwards there is a coming down. So that's a climax. The climax is usually achieved when the test leads up to an event, phase, mood or feeling of importance. There are two scenes which add to this effect in the poem. Finally, all the athletes turn round to help the runner who had fallen down is a respected. Secondly, the race ended with each runner winning a gold medal is also not anticipated. So here, very strangely, there are two climaxes. Normally, a story or a poem or a drama, there is one climax. Here there are two climaxes. The first climax is reached when the pistol sound went off, or the athletes started to run, and one, the youngest among them, he stumbled and staggered and fell down. Then all of them stopped in their tracks. One by one, when they came back, and they lifted the young lad up. It's very unexpected. They participate in Olympic Games, the most prestigious medal with which you have to want to go back to your country, personal gain and gain for the country. So nobody would like to lose it. But One by one they came back, an expected event. And not only they came back, they lifted the lad together and they together walked. So that is the first climax. Then second climax comes. So they decided to forgo their Olympic medal. No gold, no silver, no bronze. We shall forgo everything. Now, at present, we want to feel with the fellow who fell down and who lost all his hopes. We want to comfort him. Then they together, they put their hands together and they walk to the finishing line. Second climax comes when the Olympic Committee saw this strange event. They were so much encouraged. They were enthused. And they decide that all the 9 should be given a gold medal each. Instead of one getting a gold medal, one silver, one bronze, only 3 medals altogether, they said all the other medals are cancelled, only gold medals should be given and to every one of the 9 team members. That is the second climax. Very unexpected thing has happened. Then there is a critical remark. You can have a look at it. Special Olympics. As we read the poem, we come to know that the 100 meters race is an event organized in Special Olympics. Special Olympics is the world's largest sports organization for people with disabilities. They call it with different words. They call people with disabilities. They say people differently abled. No more we say handicapped. You don't say handicapped. We don't. There are so many words, but now they say the best word. Earlier they were saying the best word to use is differently abled. But now they are saying people with disabilities is the best word. The best phrase to explain this kind of people is people with disabilities. Disabilities. Some of their abilities are not there. Maybe in hand, maybe legs, or any part of the body, certain disabilities, not able to function. This organization helps these people to develop self-confidence and social skills. So this is the biggest event organized in the world. So what is the aim of it? To develop self-confidence and social skills among the disabled people. It conducts Special Olympics, World Games every 2 years. You must remember, rather, normal Olympics is once in 4 years. This is once in 2 years. And provides children and adults with disabilities year-round training. They give year-round training for the disabled people to make them to participate in the Special Olympics. As a global movement, Special Olympics aim at making the world better, healthier, and more joyful place. So that is the aim of this Special Olympics. Making world better, healthier, and a joyful place. The runners participating in the race is Special Olympics disabled, displayed friendliness, kindness, team spirit, and cooperation that we have already seen. They empathized with the one who had fallen down and helped him instantly at the cost of losing the race. We already learned the word empathize and sympathize. Empathize means they were able to get into the feelings of the other, able to feel with them. They empathized with the one who had fallen down and helped him instantly. Instantly means immediately, at the cost of losing the race. What was the cost? They were to lose the Olympic medal. They would have got a gold or silver or bronze. They sacrificed that in order to help the other. This act of selflessness. What is selflessness? Where there is no self, aham. We call it Sanskrit, aham. There is no selfishness. So what is the opposite of selflessness? Is selfish. Opposite of selflessness is selfishness. When you are selfish, you want to possess everything. Others, you don't care for others. that is selfishness. Selflessness means I'm concerned about the other. So this was a great act of selflessness. Compelled the narrator to say that the banner that read Special Olympics could not have been nearer the mark. Last I explained the meaning of could not have been nearer the mark. Very difficult to follow. I suppose you remember. Could not have been nearer the mark means that was nearest to the mark. It was nearest to the mark. It could not have been any way better. The best way to do it was that. That's the meaning of it. So they made the title Special Olympics much more special by the act of selflessness. By sacrificing their medals, they decided to help out the other. So only these are the points you have to remember. Then the assignments are there. The assignments you will find, all the assignments are very easy. You can just go through them. If you find it difficult, any of the numbers, not many are there. I think there are only 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. Only 4 are there. So you go through the assignments and suppose you find any one of it. Suppose you say, I'm finding it assignment number 1, which is a section, you can just send a message to me. I can help you out in the class. Otherwise, with this, we are stopping. So we have finished all our poems. We have finished all the stories. Now what is left is only drama. Kumar Chakravarti.